Hi, my name is Julie Chang, and I'm the creator of 940. As in, there are only 940 weekends from the time your child is born till they go to college.
940.
940.
Okay, without sounding dramatic, I've been on my own since I was 15 years old. I also battled and survived a brain tumor. I'm also a mom of two, and all of these journeys combined have given me a very unique perspective on time. That's what 940 is about. Actionable, accessible ideas that make this all easier. And gosh, I don't know, maybe fun? If 940 had a mission statement, it would be this.
Make time better for people who matter.
In this episode, we explore the power of communication.
Allow me to do a proper introduction. Destiny Bennett, please welcome her to the 940 stage. The plants are going wild. We're entering year three of these wild times. Blessing and a curse in the sense, I feel like this moment, this chaos, provided space for you to really shine and show your tools. Talk about that video that went viral for you.
My mom did in-home childcare for 18 years. I just naturally grew up in an environment of being around different kids and the emotions and all that. I did briefly study early childhood development when my oldest was a baby. And then I ended up dropping out of school just because it was the mom life was a lot. You know, my husband was in the military. Communication is definitely something I'm trying to instill in my boys at a young age because it's something that wasn't instilled in me.
But how did you reach that point on your own in the sense, like, I didn't grow up like you with model behavior. My parents used awful language. The tone, the volume levels, they were very much reacting versus responding. So if that wasn't modeled for you, how did you decide, like, I want to be different?
Yelling was a big part of our household. Like, it was very much like, if I'm feeling this way, everybody's going to know it. Those things that triggered me as a child that still, you know, trigger me as an adult sometimes, I knew that I didn't want to communicate that way.
What do you feel like is the top three communication mistake that parents make nowadays?
Ooh, that's a good question. Parents underestimate their children's ability to communicate verbally, non-verbally. They're little people. They're very capable. In my viral video, people are like, you're talking way too much. You know, like, he doesn't understand any of that.
Sometimes feeling better is getting the things that we want, but sometimes we can't get the things we want. And it's okay to be angry, but then we have to be able to let it go.
Like, I've been talking to him since he was a baby. A lot of people may think he doesn't understand. I can ask him exactly, like, what did mommy say? How did that make you feel? And he can communicate that back to me. Number two, how our language and how we communicate impacts how our children communicate. Parents who, their kids start cussing, and it's like, oh my God, you're cussing, shame on you, you know, like, you know you're not supposed to talk like that, but then that same parent, when they're talking to friends or they're talking to family or other people, they're cursing.
Shame.
What's the third one you think is a common pitfall? Like, I see a lot of bribing happening, and by that I mean, if you do this, you get a lollipop. If you stop this, you get a popsicle, like.
Definitely. I've struggled with that too. I think kind of closing in on all of that would be boundaries. Like, I respect you. I want to hear, you know, how you're feeling. You can talk to me, but also this boundary of like, I am still your parent.
The top three most powerful communication tools for your kids. For myself, one of the most powerful speech changes has been changing the word if to when. When I change that if to a when, I find that it changes from a threat to a reward. If you don't do this, this is gonna happen. Whereas I say, you know, hey, when you can make your bed, we can go downstairs and make chocolate chip pancakes or something positive.
Right. I try not to force my thoughts, my opinion on them when they're upset and really like catering to whatever their need is in that moment. Mm-hmm. And then coming back, talking to them when they're more mentally capable of receiving it. The video, the doorbell cam, is like, I was getting so frustrated in that moment because it had been like a whole like hour of just attitude, sometimes just getting on his level and like speaking to him with compassion in that moment is what he needs to be able to grasp whatever I'm trying to get across to him.
These are tools like literally cloaked in, oh, this is how you talk to children. No, but we should talk to everyone this way. Nobody can even take in what you're saying if you're in that activated state.
I've had so many moms reach out to me that are like, I tried everything with my kid and I did the blowing technique and like it worked. It made me really, really happy that I found something and that like by putting that out there, so many other people were able to find something as well.
So far, what I'm gathering is your power of communication with your three boys, who are all very different from each other, is talk to them as an equal. Also, it's a case by case. Each kid is different. Each scenario is different. So just try multitude of things and see what sticks.
I feel like our communication is a balance of empathy and boundaries.
So much easier said than done.
For me too.
You are like a master of deflecting. This river of emotions that your kids are going through come at you. And somehow you're able to deflect that into the most calm, serene, still water. I will tell you what I try to do is, this is kind of morbid, but I once read a story about a mother who had lost her son. One of the big things that they always argued about was he would always slam the back screen door when he would come into the house. And she would tell him 100 times a day, I told you not to slam that door. And after he passed, she's like, what I would pay to hear that door slam again. I know, I get worked up. And so whenever they're having tantrums, I think about, God forbid anything happens, these are the moments I will pray for. And so that's how I try to like deflect my own anger and frustration with them in those moments.
Right.
How do you switch it? Like, I want to know your technique because mine seems a little morbid. Like, tell me you have a little happier technique.
It's a little morbid, but I feel like it's very normal. I definitely do that too. I try to have like that gratitude and appreciation with all of my encounters with them, even the not so positive ones. A lot of our capability to deal with our children comes with how we take care of ourselves.
Self-care is a selfless thing, right?
Yes, self-care, self-development, like our sense of spirituality. Dude, we are the foundation for our children. So if our foundation is cracked, everything's cracked. First thing when I wake up in the morning, I meditate. If I have to lock the door and my kids are at the door banging for breakfast, I have to meditate because I can't function to make breakfast without an attitude if I don't get my mind, you know, my mind right in the morning.
Yes, it's like you cannot fill others' cups if your pitcher is empty.
Yes. But I found like the days that I'm able to meditate. I'm able to like read a little bit. I'm able to center myself. I'm much more equipped to deal with my kids than the days when I just wake up and just go straight at it.
Three boys under eight for your oldest. You're halfway through the 940 weekends.
We're a very, very close-knit family. My kids are homeschooled and we spend a lot of time together. We're blessed to be able to work from home. It's funny because my oldest is the one, he's like, I'm never moving out. I'm gonna live with you guys forever. Like, we're always gonna be a family. And like, that it just makes me so happy and sad at the same time because I communicate with so many parents and like so many parents, like my, you know, like, that seems like my ear doesn't wanna hang out with me. You know, my 11-year-old, like, screams at me if I come in his room. It does make me emotional in the sense that like, I feel like I must be doing something right for him to like want to be so close.
We'll resume this conversation when he's 50 and still living in his house.
Right.
Do you try to savor time in a specific way? Like, things are going too fast. This is the one thing I do to just kind of harness time.
And I try to spend like individual time with them. Like that's my big thing right now. Like you get one-on-one with your child. That's when you really get to see them like
magic, right?
Yeah. And it's like a part of them that you don't see on an everyday basis.
Like that, you compartmentalize with each family member. It's so important, especially you and your husband carve out time for yourselves. What is the most powerful phrase you say to your children?
I love you. I feel like that was something that was said to me so much growing up. And it was like, despite the disagreements or anything that went on between my mom and I've always felt love. That's the difference between my mom and my dad, who like rarely ever told me he loved me. That's always been something that's really important to me, is like, I want them to know how loved they are. And then something I say to them all the time, you're amazing. you're amazing. You know, I make them like mimic that back to themselves. Like, you know how amazing you are? Like, yeah, I'm amazing. Because I want them to know just like how valuable they are.
I'm like probably creepy mom. Like right when they're about to fall asleep at night, I go right up to their ear and I like whisper a few affirmations. You did this today. You wowed me this way.
Yes.
And I just feel like that will go into the deep memory.
Oh, it does. It does. I actually made a video about that. It's like a form of hypnosis. And it does. It goes into their subconscious.
Do you feel like the beauty of this interesting time where everyone is like trying to find deep connection? When you see another mama like on the path, it's like you almost like lock eyes and you're like, I see you.
Yes.
I had that moment with you.
Oh, that makes me so happy.
And you get bombarded with people reaching out to you. So when you responded back, I was like, she sees me on the path.
Yes.
I'm like way further along the path, but you're waving at you from the back.
I'm right. Like, we're all there. We're in a line. We're going. Yes. I've always loved motherhood. I love other moms, like such a special, like, sisterhood.
Hit the like, hit subscribe, hit the like, hit subscribe, hit the like, hit subscribe.